Well, if any of you watch my video series on rebuilding my table saw, you know that I'm now I now own a Jessam mast-r-lift 2 router lift and a big three and a quarter horsepower Milwaukee. And my very super cool tools T-square jumps from my table saw configuration over to my router table configuration here because I couldn't make it work to the right of the blade because of this beautiful cast iron top. But I'm just now really learning how to use a router table after many, many years of never using one. So we've got a couple fences that I want to show you that attach to the very super cool tools T-square. This is the one that Jeff designed. This would allow you to use very large bits because you can open and close this mouth here. And this works fantastic, and this has incredible dust control through this place here. You can either put a friction fit fitting on it in any direction that you like, or I added set T-nuts down in here, prong T-nuts, so you can use a flange mount also. So you can use it in either way. But with the dust collection going, the dust just races down this channel and evacuates out. It's really pretty phenomenal. And so this works really good, and then this would also give you the opportunity if you wanted to do some type of offset router fence setup here, where you could just shim the backside with some accurate shims to create a step over, much like a joiner. And so this will work very well for that. And of course, it just attaches to the T-square by standard T-nuts. So they'll just come on here like this and just slip into the slots of the extrusion and then slide and lock down anywhere you like them to. And so it works real well. One of the small differences that I did when I made this over Jeff's was I used a different type of bolt. I used a cap head or a socket head bolt, and so when it comes all the way back, it bottoms out inside this and can't come out, instead of a countersunk shorter bolt that could possibly fall out. So that was something I did. But so Jeff has the videos and the plans for the one he made like this, and like I said, there's a couple changes. I think all he did was the friction fit with the circle cutter, and I added the ability to have a flange mount on here too, because you can get these flange mounted dust collection fittings pretty reasonable from Woodcraft, and they always have them on sale. And so I'm gonna let this one, I'm gonna let Jeff's video demonstrate this one, but then I wanted some other options too with this router, with this whole router table idea. So this one is what I'm calling the continuous router fence, and this has the dust control on the back also in either a friction or a flange mounted setup. And this is a little different in that instead of the channels being separated like this, this has the connectors top and bottom, and it's an open channel in here. And what I did is I made it to where I haven't even used this yet, that's why it hasn't been cut into. Zero clearance insert, that's what I'm calling this, is a zero clearance insert or some kind of custom insert. I'm looking for my ball driver. I must have just set it down. Oh, here it is. So most of the time, like I said, I've used this, but I haven't even cut into it yet. And I made four additional ones. You'll see, this is the video series I made to show you this setup. And this just pulls down and also has levelers too, so you can get it dialed in absolutely perfect to the face of the fence. But here's where primarily I'm going to use it like this, where it's got this chamfered piece right here, and so far what I've seen, the dust extraction is just unreal. And So it's working really well. And then this also has the, well, both of them work with the gessum TS guides. The gessum TS guides will reach over, and you can see that there's a rabbit cut here, so it allows the little bit of overhang of the TS guides off the extrusion. It accommodates that. But so both of them work with that, no problem. But the other thing I wanted to do is I also wanted to integrate into this one of my very super cool tools, high auxiliary fences, and the ability to add a high fence if I was doing something like cutting sliding dovetails on drawer frames or something, which I do a lot of. So you're trying to stand a piece up and, you know, position it over a dovetail bit on a router table, you know, you tip it a little bit and you kind of mess your cuts up. So this also has T-nuts in here, so just a standard quarter 20 will come through the countersunk bolt holes on the front of the auxiliary fence, and the hole pattern lines up perfectly. So now you can attach this. And like I said, I know there's going to be some times where I'm going to want to cut through this, but I don't mind sacrificing. I've got so many of these things. I've just made a bunch of them. And you can see this one's really trashed out from some pretty trashy work that it gets subjected to. But I think these two router fences should cover all of my router table needs and have incredible dust control at the same time. And they did not take that much time to make, and certainly the materials were materials that I got, you know, from around my shop that were just leaning against the wall. Nothing, you know, I didn't have to buy anything. I had scrap laminate left over from building that. And so, you know, there's not much in materials in this. And then just some hardware, and, you know, those dust collecting fittings are, I think, what was this one? This one, well, this was pretty expensive. This one was $7.89, so that's pretty expensive. But I know that one was under $5, that flange mounted one, when I got it, because everything was on sale at 25% off. I think that one was too, so 25 off that. So let me place this over here, and I'll give you an idea how this works, and then I'll make some cuts. Thanks for watching. We have woodworking plans available in our store, and we'll continue to add more. Each set of plans corresponds with a free video series available on YouTube.